Hello everybody, my name is Teresa Castillo and for today's process speech, I will be teaching everybody how to embroider. I absolutely love embroidery. It is a very relaxing and enjoyable craft. There is a lot to, you know, it is pretty simple, but there is a lot to learn. And once you understand more of the basics, then you have a better understanding on how to do everything. But I will save that for a little bit later and go ahead and start. So in this process speech, we're going to be discussing the necessary equipment to actually embroider, basic steps and rules, but there are more steps rather than rules because it is a very creative craft, and then how to actually start doing it. So to begin, we're going to talk about like some of the necessary tools that you need. I do have them with me, but I'm not going to take them out because it's just going to create too much chaos. But I do have pictures of how, you know, so it'll be better. You'll be able to actually see it. And the good thing about embroidery is that it's a very inexpensive thing to get into. You know, they're very easy to access. You can access it in like all of the local craft stores, but they do have them like in, you know, your regular stores, like Target, Walmart, like those kind of places. They also have them there as well. And again, like they are not expensive at all. So for starters, I want to talk about, I'm going to show a picture. Let's see if y'all can see it appropriately. For starters, I wanted to talk about like this hoop. This is very important because you have to be able to put like your fabric in there, and then the with the hoop's help, you're able to tighten the fabric up better so that when you're trying to actually insert the needle, it won't, you know, bundle up and stuff, and it's much cleaner to do. I wouldn't recommend doing it without one. You need your scissors. Well, I'll start this way. You need your needles. They do have like special embroidery needles, not expensive at all. And then all sorts and kinds and, you know, kinds of threads that you are able to use. There are all kinds of colors. Like I said, like it is very creative. Like you can do anything with them. And then like in order to, you know, clean up your work, and then like when you're cutting your thread, you do need some sort of scissors. I just have like basic scissors. I don't have anything fancy yet. I am slowly trying to build my crafting box of, you know, of those things. And then I wanted to go ahead and just start jumping into like kind of like a step-by-step on how to do it. Just so could, because you kind of have like a clear understanding on like how to actually do it or what's equipment that you need, so you know we can go ahead and start talking about it. In this case, I don't have any pictures because it's mostly like video based, but basic steps that you do are, you know, you have to choose your fabric, and you kind of have to have an idea as to what you want to do sort of. You pick your thread, and the thread bundles, let me go back to it. The thread bundles kind of usually come in like six. So they're like all kind of like bundled together, and then it creates like, you know, this big long thread. You can easily separate those, and normally people always do like two to three threads because that's like the perfect, you know, thickness, that because in order to like avoid like making a hole in fabric, or you know, the actual like thread and the string and stuff be too thick, you want to keep it like in a good, you know, a good width. I tend to always do like two, and then like, you know, when you fold it over, it becomes four. So, you know, you do have like a good enough line to work with, like when you're actually inserting the needle and like making the lines and the stitches. You know, it does like create like a very clean look, but it is also just easier to do it that way. Anyways, let me go back to this. And then you want you can use like kind of like outlines, or like there's like special paper that you can like draw on, and then like, you know, to have like a like an outline of certain projects if you want to do that. Really, it just comes down to inserting your thread into the needle and then just, you know, knotting it at the end, and then just going ahead and starting, you know, your threads. The next thing that I wanted to, you know, get into was that there are different types of stitches, fabrics, and ways of like doing it. So a lot of people, again, like they do it differently. I do like two threads, and then some people do more. It just depends on what you are wanting to do. I am going to show a pictures in just 1 second, but in the pictures I will be showing like different kinds of stitches and, you know, designs that you're able to. And again, like this is a very creative craft, so you can really do anything. There are all sorts of kind of crafts that include embroidery. A lot of people like do embroidery and like sewing, embroidery, you know, any of those following things. But let me go to that picture. So here we have, I don't know all the names because I am not an expert, but here is just an example of all kinds of threads that they have and all these kind of designs that you can have in your embroidery projects. And then this is a second one. They do have the names on there. You have a French knot, bag, chain, stem, lazy daisy, stars, like, you know, you have like rosebuds that aren't on here, but they were on the previous page, that you are able to master. And it does require patience, but I believe that it's very rewarding just because it is a very relaxing craft. Let's see. And just in summary, there is a lot to learn, and there is a lot of types of projects that can be done. But it is a beautiful craft that does require patience, but it is peaceful and those kinds of things. We have already discussed, you know, like the equipment that we need in order to embroider, the essential steps to do beforehand before you actually start embroidering, and how to, you know, like choosing the needle, choosing like your thread, choosing your fabric, and then how to successfully do embroidery. There is a lot of videos out there, you know, that do show like a way more descriptive way of doing it. I hope you guys enjoyed